What's up, guys? This is Russell here from neosather.com with another installment of NS Game Review's First Impressions. So last time, I took a look at Metal Gear Rising on the Xbox 360 and mentioned that I do have some familiarity with the Metal Gear series, both with the Metal Gear on the NES and Metal Gear Solid 1 and 4 on the PlayStation systems. Now, though, I'm going to take a look at a demo in a series I have almost no familiarity with, and that's Naruto. I've tried watching the Naruto anime. I just can't get into it. I think it's the character of Naruto himself is what drives me nuts. Though I have played a couple of demos in the past for the GameCube and the PSP. And I actually wouldn't mind trying the card game. I can't even remember if I have a deck for it. If not, I'll have to pick one up at Gen Con and do a review on it. But in terms of the actual demo itself, this one's not too bad. It starts off with a 4-minute anime-style story. I'm not joking here. It's about 4 minutes. And the game even tells you it's 4 minutes. Where it has the third Hokage, I'm sure I'm butchering that. Minato Nimikaze, and I'm sure I probably butchered that. Risking his life to save the Hidden Leaf Village from an attack by the Ninetales. And again, I don't have a lot of experience with Naruto, so pardon me if I seem ignorant on any of this. So he winds up deflecting an attack somewhere, and then he gets encountered by a masked man, but he's able to escape him. Meanwhile, the third Hokage leads an attack on the Ninetales in the Hidden Leaf Village. And I apologize a minute ago, I think I called Minato, the third Hokage. He's actually the fourth. That's my bad. And I'm really at a loss for words here. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like the demo. I'm just not sure exactly how I want to put this. Controls are relatively simple at first. I mean, there's not really much complicated about it. Use the control stick to move. During the Ninetales battle, you can kind of move left and right, you can jump between buildings. You can kind of jump towards and away from the Ninetales a little bit to kind of get in range for melee attacks when the game allows you. Well, technically, you probably can whenever you want, but until you get the announcement that Ninetales is moving a little sluggish or has kind of stopped his attacks, trying to go in for melee is not good, so you want to use X to use your shurikens. You can also hold Y for what's called chakra load, which I'm guessing is some sort of like spells and stuff in the series. I mean, I've heard the term chakra, but that's just about it. This was kind of the downfall of the demo, in that there's actually two fights you're going through, but in both fights, well, the first fight, you really don't get much of a chance to use your chakras, I mean, because you're constantly running from Ninetales attacks. Of course, I could have also just been doing it wrong. Because I guess you hold down Y to charge an attack, and then hit X or B, I believe, to do a attack, depending on how much you charged up. Later on in the fight, you can also hit left bumper to call in reinforcements. And when that happens, and you get to a reinforcement when they're ready, you can hit B, I believe, and start a quick time event. The faster you do the inputs on the quick time events when they show up, you get these stars, and the more stars you get by the end of the battle, you can see like a little secret video or something that gives you a bit of a background, I guess, on things. I didn't get it on the Ninetales battle. I did on the, at least I don't think I did, I don't know. Thinking from memory right now, I'm not sure. The Masked Man battle later on, I know I did. With the Masked Man battle, it's essentially the same thing, except instead of a giant beast, you're going up against a masked man. Neither battle is really that difficult. I mean, with the Ninetales, as long as you're just constantly running and jumping and paying attention to what's going on screen, there's not a whole lot to really worry about. And when you can get in for melee attacks, get in, get about a good 3 or 4 swings, and then just get back. If you stay there too long, Ninetales will regroup and smash you. With the Masked Man battle, I did get a little more of a chance to check out the chakra attacks, namely the dash. And what I like is that Minato has a bit of a teleport, it seems. I decided just to rapidly hit A, thinking, hey, he's a ninja, maybe he can double jump. Well, he can't double jump, but he can teleport, which is nice. Kind of get a little teleport dash. I honestly think, I think similar to Shenko, I believe it is, in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Where her ground dash is kind of like a little teleport. So, similar. So, that's really all there is to the demo. I mean, it's not like Metal Gear where you're going through a stage and then you got a boss battle and then you're getting your butt kicked by a robotic dog. This is pretty much just two boss battles. So, on that note, it is a bit of a letdown that's just two boss battles. I mean, again, in Metal Gear Solid, you had a stage and a boss. Devil May Cry, you had a stage and a boss, even though they were different parts of the game. I'm not even sure if the two battles are actually close to each other in the game. Like, if you fight the Ninetales and then you immediately fight the Masked Man. I'm not sure. I'm not sure when the battle itself takes place. Whereas, at least with Metal Gear Rising, it looked like that was the first stage that I went through. So yeah, overall, if you're a fan of Naruto, I'd say at least give the demo a shot. This might be a game that I might want to pick up later on down the road, depending on what reviews of it look like. So, pardon my yawning, that's really all I have on this one. So, thank you for joining me on my little look at, Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 3 on the Xbox 360. If you have any questions, comments, I got a game demo you want me to check out, which this is actually, I believe, the newest demo online, for at least for the Xbox 360. Send me an email at nsgr@neocyther.com. And that's all I got. So thank you for joining me. Until next time, see you later.